Will there be animals in heaven? Well, I would like to read something to you out of Randy Alcorn's book called Heaven. The scripture says a great deal about animals, portraying them as Earth's second most important inhabitants. God entrusted animals to us, and our relationships with animals are a significant part of our lives. Isaiah 11:6-9 speaks of a coming glorious era on Earth, when the leopard will lie down with the goat and the calf and the lion and the yearling together, and a little child will lead them. The cow will feed with the bear, their young will lie down together, and the lion will eat straw like the ox. The infant will play near the hole of the cobra, and the young child put his hand into the viper's nest. They will neither harm nor destroy on all my holy mountain, for the earth will be full of the knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea. Why did God save the animals from the flood? God said to Noah and to his sons with him, I now establish my covenant with you and your descendants after you, and with every living creature that was with you, the birds, the livestock, and all the wild animals, and all that came out of the ark with you, every living creature on earth. This is a sign of the covenant. Never again will there be a flood to destroy the earth. I will remember my covenant between you and all the living creatures. Whenever the rainbow appears in the clouds, I will see it and remember the everlasting covenant between God and all living creatures of every kind on the earth. So God said to Noah, this is the sign of the covenant I have established between me and all life on the earth. And you can refer to Genesis 9, chapter 9, or verse 9 through 17. God created us to be stewards of animals. He holds us accountable for how we treat them. The godly are concerned for the welfare of their animals, Proverbs 12:10. We are caretakers for the animals, but they belong to God, not us. For all the animals of the forest are mine, and I own the cattle on a thousand hills. Every bird of the mountains and all the animals of the field, they belong to me. Psalm 50:10-11. Do the animals praise the Lord? Passages in Revelation also indicate that the animals will praise their Creator. Then I heard every creature in heaven and on earth and under the earth, on the sea, and all that is singing to Him. To Him who sits on the throne and the Lamb be praise and honor and glory and power forever and ever. To sing praises to God and worship, is that what these creatures do? If every creature in heaven and on earth, that includes animals, then yes, animals do praise God.
We are to be me and awesome.